Hi, everyone, and welcome back to our last lesson about learning Figma as a product person. We are learning how to build a lightweight prototype. We have our wonderful designer advocate, Lauren, here teaching us. My name is Katie. I'm our Figma advocate here, and we are going to dig in today all into sharing and feedback. So once we have our prototype ready, I'm going to be doing the homework tonight, get us ready for sharing and feedback. But today, Lauren's going to teach us, how do we do that? How do we share out once we're ready and get feedback from our stakeholders? So Lauren, where do we start with sharing?
Yes, let's pop into our file over here. So first thing we're gonna go to is we're gonna go to that big old share button right here. This is where we're gonna be able to grab some links. A couple of things we wanna focus on here are basically the permissions. What do we want people to be able to do once they get into our file? Do we want them to just be able to view it? So we don't really want them touching anything. We just want them to be able to see what's going on. Are we collaborating with them? In our case, we wanna both be able to move things around in our file. So we wanna change that to can edit. Or there's just can view prototypes. So they'll only be able to view the prototypes there. I feel like a lot of times you're gonna be, if you're sending them to your team and you're in that collaboration mode, you're gonna wanna have it on can edit. So we'll set it to that. And then you can either type in the name, your emails here of the folks that you wanna send it to. If I started typing in Katie on here, you'll show up here. So it'll start to recognize you. So we can just put on Katie, great. And then we'll be able to share that invite there and they will get a notification, which brings us back to one of our original lessons of where those notifications are right up in our, it was in the left-hand side up here. So they'd get a notification there when we share that.
Right. So I'll probably be sharing both with my team to get their input on things and then also with cross-functional stakeholders, or I might just add them as a viewer. Is there an easier way if I have a group of folks and I want to share it maybe in Slack or something like that, that I could just have something that I can share with them without having to input everyone's email in here?
Totally. Yeah. So then you're just probably going to want to copy the link. So you can do that right up here. That'll copy the link to the file. There's also, okay, if you wanted to very specifically copy like the link to a frame, so this specific frame, yeah. I could do Command L and you could see this popped up, frame link copied. So that will direct them exactly to that link or that frame once they get into the file. So you can do that with the frames. You can do it to this section, Command L, and that'll copy a little bit more of a specific area to drop them right into that. And then you can just share it with folks that way.
That's great. That's super helpful then. If I want, say, my designer to help out in the specific frame or something like that, I can send in there. I think the case I'll more often be doing is sharing that prototype once we have the final prototype set up. Mm-hmm. Is there a way that I can share from that present mode that we were in before?
Yeah, absolutely. So if we go back into our present mode over here, and then once that loads, same type of thing, this button will be right up in this top right-hand corner, share prototype, and you'll have the same type of information here of you can copy the link or you can start to input folks' emails in here and share it right that way.
Perfect. And when I'm sharing from this view, is it just sharing this prototype or they also have access to the backend file?
So it'll just share this prototype. So you're going to want to, if you want to get them into this file as well, that'll be a different link.
Yeah. Awesome. Cool. That's exactly what I think we need. And then the last thing to talk about here is commenting, like getting their feedback. Mm-hmm. Usually I'm the one that gets one of these links and comes in here and starts commenting up, but how do we get our stakeholders to now provide that feedback on this now that we've created it?
Totally. So that'll just be the shortcut C. That'll bring up your comments or right over here on our left-hand side, the little speech bubble here, clicking on that. And then within your prototype, you can just comment anywhere on here. You can at somebody. So if I at you, at Katie, that will then give you a notification. Hey. And then again, we showed this in last time. If we go back into our files here, it's sharing it exactly where we were. So we can comment same thing from the files going right up to our comments, popping it right here. So that's one of the really handy ways to share feedback there. Another way that I love too, which is like live feedback, if you're in the file, is cursor chat. This one, I don't think we've talked about this one yet, but super handy. If you're like right here in this file with me, I can just talk to you. And I did that by doing the slash. So right where your question mark is on your keyboard. That's also a fun way to communicate within the file. If you want something that's less permanent and just in the moment situation, that's really handy there. But comments are great for being more permanent and having anybody be able to come in and check those out later on.
Super handy. Can we also just talk about how I know who's in the file? If I'm like working in here and how do I know if someone else is checking out the thing that I've shared?
Yeah, totally. You'll be able to see up here and up here, I mean, on the top right-hand corner over here, who is in this file. And I'm not sure if we talked about spotlighting or not yet, but I can click on you to see where you are. Mm. You can also hide those cursors too if you would prefer not to see who's in your file. You just want to focus on one thing. Yeah. We can hide the cursors down here with turning off multiplayer cursor. Okay. But being able to follow somebody is actually really handy too. In prototypes, you can follow them. So if I'm selected on your face in our prototype and you're clicking the arrows back and forth, you can see I'm not doing anything right now, but our stuff is moving. So that can be really handy in presentations to follow somebody in presentation mode.
Oh, that's great. And can you switch back and forth between different folks?
So who's ever in here, I could just click on their face. If I'm all set following you, I'll just click elsewhere. And now I'm no longer following you. Now I can control it myself.
Fantastic. Love that. And then I think when we were talking about the prototyping initially, you talked about some other options of if it's not fitting to the screen. Sometimes when I get into this prototype, everything's way too big.
Yeah.
How do I get it to be fit within what I need to see here?
Yeah, so that's probably going to be up in our options of fit to screen, fill screen. Let's see if we were actual size. So actual size right here, we can see is a little too big for us. So I usually default to fit to screen to make sure the whole thing is actually fitting in here.
Okay. And then I think the last question I have is, so often I'll leave comments in @mentionmydesigner, they go through them and then they disappear from our view. Mm-hmm. If people are leaving comments for me and I want to work through the feedback that people are leaving, how do I clear them out as I go?
Yeah, so if we pop over to this comment over here, we can either click on this check and that's resolve comment. So now it's gone. If I do shift C, so that's comments hidden, comments visible over here. I can look, and when I'm still, I clicked on my comment, add comment up here, and I can see them over here. There's nothing here because I've resolved them. But if there is a situation where you're like, oh, I know Lauren told me something a while ago, I resolved it, but what was that? You can find them again. If you go up into the settings, I can see a couple of different things. I can see mentions and replies. I can also, if there's another icon to the left of that, where I can see show resolved comments. So I just clicked on that and pretty much all the comments that we've had in here, we can see now. So we can also just see only current page. There's a lot to sort by if the comments start to get a little bit overwhelming. There's a couple of different ways to sort.
Awesome. That's so powerful. So I can get all the feedback I need, work through it, I go, and then be able to find the specific feedback based on those filters there. Mm-hmm. Awesome.
The one other thing that I'd say too is going with like the cursor chat of, so we have our comments, our permanent ones, or like a little bit more permanent because obviously you can resolve them. The cursor chat is in the moment. Another in the moment one is the headphones icon up here, the conversation. That's available on certain plans, but that one is basically if you're in the file with somebody and the cursor chat is just not quite enough, you need to actually talk to them. That's a really good way to communicate with folks if you can just literally get on a conversation there together in the file, which is always fun.
That is so fun. I have a secret Figma file party.
Yeah, exactly.
Love that. Awesome. I think I have everything I need now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all this back from the second half of our lesson, put all this into our homework, and I am going to share my first prototype with you tomorrow.
Yes, I can't wait to see it.
I'll bring that back, get your feedback, get some actionable ways to level it up, and then also answer some open questions that I have.
Amazing. Can't wait.
Perfect. Thanks so much, Lauren.
You bet. See you soon.
Bye.